I have been a software engineering manager at Meta and other FAANG companies for almost 7 years. I have coached a lot of junior engineers and have them build great careers. Helping them, I have learned a few things that can help each one of you. There's tons of advice online, but they're fairly generic. For example, have higher impact, make better decisions, or get a great mentor. These are great, but they aren't things which you can just start doing on a day-to-day basis. I'm stoked to share these 9 practical tips that can immediately change how you operate as a software engineer. So let's get started. Number 9, master the art of prioritization. I want to talk about something that's super important for all of us software engineers out there. Prioritization. I get it. We are all busy juggling multiple tasks and projects at once. It's easy to get caught up in the weeds and lose sight of what really matters the most. But trust me, learning how to prioritize effectively can be a total game changer. Let me give you an example. You're busy working on refactoring this old legacy codes, right? It's a tedious task, but it will make the code base way more maintainable down the line. But at the same time, there's a high priority bug in the app's checkout flow, and it's severely impacting the customers and the business. If you spend too much time on that refactoring task while the bug lingers, you could seriously be impacting the user experience and the business impact. That's where prioritization comes in. It's about taking a step back and looking at the bigger picture. What tasks are going to have the biggest impact on your goals and the customer's needs? Those are the ones you want to tackle first. So what can you do? Work with your team to establish a clear framework for evaluating and ranking your tasks. Consider factors like business impact, technical complexity, dependencies of other teams on your project. Having that framework in place will make you stay objective and make sure you're focusing your efforts on the right things at the right time. Number 8, always be closing. As an engineering owner, you're responsible to close all your tickets, pull requests, design docs, and so on. Even if you depend on others who might be more busy, might be more senior, you don't have to sit back and wait. You are in the driver's seat. You are the owner. Be courteous, direct, crystal clear, and always be closing. So for example, on a design doc, you can always say, "Thanks, I have incorporated this feedback, but I'll close this thread," and feel free to open if you have more questions. Closing tasks properly don't just save you time and headaches, it also changes how your peers perceive you. When you constantly close loops, update statuses, and don't leave your loose ends, you build a reputation as someone reliable and accountable. Your teammates know they can count on you to truly complete the work. Number 7, ask questions and ask often. Don't be afraid to ask for help when you are stuck. There's no shame in it, and in fact, it's a sign of strength and self-awareness. Try to unblock yourself first, but if you are still spinning after an hour or so, it's time to reach out. Aim to ask questions at least twice a day, whether it's in Slack, in stand-up, or in the good old-fashioned face-to-face conversations. Trust me, your teammates would much rather help you get unstuck than you have waste hours banging your head against the wall. Number 6, recommend a solution. When it comes to design decisions or recommendations, always make sure to provide your own take. Don't just present a bunch of options and say, "Well, what do you think?" Adding a recommendation forces you to apply critical thinking, and it makes the review process way more effective. Your teammates will be able to focus their energy on scrutinizing and discussing your recommended option, rather than trying to guess which one you prefer. Even if the team ultimately disagrees with your recommendation, that's a win. The goal isn't to be right 100% of the time. It's to align the team on a decision quickly and efficiently. If the information and thought process you provided helped facilitate the alignment, then the mission is accomplished, right? Number 5, bottom line upfront. This one's straight out of the military playbook, and it's all about communicating clearly and concisely. Don't bury the lead or tease out your main point. Get right to it. People are busy and their time is valuable, so respect that by getting to the point quickly and clearly. It's all too easy to fall into the trap of providing a ton of context and background information before finally getting to the crux of the matter. But by that point, audience may have already tuned out. BLUF helps you avoid that by forcing you to lead with the most important details right off the bat. Number 4, run towards a conflict. Conflicts, design uncertainties, and product risks, they are inevitable in our line of work. Rather than trying to outrun them, spoiler alert, you can't, run towards them head first. It's often cheaper and less painful to deal with these things sooner rather than later. A common example is reviewing your design sketch before diving into the full design. If you can identify and address potential conflicts, you'll save yourself a ton of time and headaches down the road. So whenever you see a potential conflict, try to debug it instead of avoiding it. The next set of three tips are perhaps the most important one. They are all about learning. So number three, learn from your peers. One of the best ways to grow is to learn from those around you. Before submitting a PR for review, read through it one more time and look for feedback you have received on your previous PRs. Once you have gotten a handle on that, start reviewing your teammates' code as well. You will learn more about the code base, best practices, and maybe even spot some areas for improvement that your teammates missed. It's a win-win. You get to up-level your skills, and your team benefits from your fresh perspective. Number two, read. This one's a bit of a personal passion of mine. Take the time to read at least 2 software engineering books per year. Seriously, it will level you up like nothing else. I'm talking about properly reading, taking notes, doodling diagrams, discussing with others. Don't just skim the surface, go deep. I have some recommendation of books in the comments below. An example is Designing Data-Intensive Applications by Martin Kleppman. That's a pretty famous book. And I will also tell you to learn the language deeply. Whatever language you're using at work, make it a priority to learn them in depth, all the way down to the nitty-gritty details. I'm talking about understanding things like garbage collection, generics, and even obscure topics like covariance and contravariance. And number one, and that's the biggest tip of all, be a continuous learner. The tech world moves fast, and if you're not constantly learning and evolving, you will get left behind. Set aside dedicated time to learn new technologies, frameworks, and best practices. Attend meetups. Watch talks like this one. Read blog posts, whatever works for you. The key is to never stop growing and expanding your skill set. One thing that's helped me stay on top of continuous learning game is setting a goal to read at least one technical blog or watch one tech talk at least for a week. I'll often do this during my lunch break. It's a small investment of time that can pay huge dividends in terms of keeping my skills sharp and my knowledge up to date. All right, that's a wrap, folks. I hope these tips have given you some valuable insights and actionable steps to take your software engineering career to new heights. Remember, growth is a journey, so embrace the process and enjoy the ride. And hey, if you found this useful, please share this video with your fellow developers and friends. Better yet, leave a comment below with your own growth tips or experiences. I'm always eager to learn from others. Let's keep the conversation going and help each other level up. Thank you, and see you in the next one.